Okay, so this is the part where I say I'm going to have somebody check the audio to make sure we're not echoing, because we are using StreamYard tonight. And you know how it was at StreamYard when I go ahead and talk with Tony D? I was echoing all over the place. Mm-hmm. So I need somebody to check the audio and make sure that we're sounding good. If you got people listening, so if we're echoing for whatever reason, go ahead and give us a ding-a-ling. You know what I'm saying? Doesn't sound good, Evan says. So that's Bushman, by the way. He goes by Evan now.
Oh.
Echo. Sounds like you're far away. I know what it is. I know what it is.
It's David being an ass.
Yes, no, it's probably freaking. No, it's not that. You know what? You just kiss my ass. How about that? How about you do that? Evan's over there waiting. Let's see. Cam and Mike, audio. Audio test. Tough microphone. No, that's that's why. Dumbass.
All right, here we go. Now we should be better. Give me a thumbs up there, Evan. Make sure we're on the testing grid here. You know what it was? It was the audio coming from the webcam.
That's what I said.
Will you shut up over there? Listen, if I need to go ahead and figure out how to start my lawnmower,
right?
You know that's better.
That's your area.
Right. Thank you.
That's rude.
God. Okay, you said sounds better. Okay, good. All right, we fixed it. Good. Now are we echoing, Karen? I said somebody needed because he wasn't gonna.
Well,
do
I thought
it.
He was the somebody.
No, he was too busy bitching at me. Give me a thumbs up there. No, we're good. Awesome. All right. We'll go ahead and get a round of applause for that. There we go. I like that. Okay. All right, shut up. Anyway, without further ado, let's go ahead and see if we can just complicate things further.
Sure.
Let's bring on Bushman, who was one of the original founders of the Charles Richardson Show. Back then, it was called the Matt Talk Show, which God knows it needed to change like big time. So let's get him on here, El Bushman, right there live. Let's see how you sound there, buddy.
What's up, buddy? How are you?
I'm good, man. How you doing, dude?
I'm good. Thanks for having me on. 6 years. I can't believe you're still on the air. 6 years. So
I know. I'm kind of shocked too. You know what it is? Basically, it has nothing to do with me getting sponsors or not or getting paid for this. It's just I've been a sucker for 6 years, just flushing my money down the toilet. It's like, well, I need to do something with my life, and I don't know.
You and me both, pal. It's all good.
Yeah. Well, listen, at least you're making waves on your end. You're over there with I just drew a blank there. What's the name of your show?
So the show now is called Play the Bay. We're on the Believe Podcast Network, which Believe is a topic-centric podcasting network. So it's focused towards athletes and professionals in the sports world. So when I pitched them the show, they're like, well, you know, we already have like a Tampa Bay centric or a Tampa Bay Buccaneers podcast that's already on the network. How would you guys like to talk about the Bucs, the Rays, and the Lightning? I'm like, well, that'd be perfect. We can, you know, talk baseball, hockey, and football, and never run out of content because everything's gonna go year round. So that's where we're at. It's going pretty well so far. I can't complain. We're having a lot of fun, myself, Kaylee, and Chip. So yeah, man, it's going pretty good.
So what happened to the name Sports Caffeine? That kind of went pretty well. I mean, for a morning show, I guess. But away from the thing.
Well, Sports Caffeine is still there. It's kind of on hiatus right now. I think because with everybody's schedules, it was kind of hard to wrangle everybody for a morning show, and that's what the original idea was. But trying to get five people on a morning show is kind of hard to do. So it's not over with that show. It's still on hiatus for the time being. I mean, we still do, once in a while shows when we're at Rafferty's for the NFL season. So we were there for the Super Bowl show and we were there for the playoffs. So Sports Caffeine isn't dead. It's just kind of on hiatus right now.
Gotcha. Well, anyway, like I said, he's gone on to bigger and better things. I'm over here stuck with people going in the mic and sniffing. He's over there talking about Bucks, Rays, and anything else to do with Tampa Bay, which, you know what?
It's a good time to be a Tampa Bay sports fan, man. It's a good time.
Right? It's either Tampa Bay or LA right now. It's one of the two. Because
yeah, that's very true.
The Lakers and Dodgers, you got the Bucks and the Lightning. It's like, you know, I think these two just need to merge together because
as Dr. Evil would say, how about new? How about new?
Well, we don't have a basketball team except for the Raptors displaced, like, just campers right now.
I mean, does anybody really pay attention to the NBA? I mean, I'm not a big basketball.
If you're in LA or Boston or New York, you do.
I mean, I'm not a big basketball guy at this point with what's going on in the NBA. I know are they even close to the playoffs with the NBA? I don't pay attention to it because I think the NBA now is just kind of a joke, to be honest with you.
So I know they just did their All-Star like a couple of weeks ago, so I know they're more than midway through.
Okay. So yeah, like I said, I don't follow the NBA that much, honestly, with the LA sports. The LA sports to me is you've got the Dodgers and then, you know, maybe the Rams, which, you know, they've made a trade this offseason to get Matthew Stafford over and whatnot. So right now, LA just to me really has the Dodgers. The Lakers are kind of a funny team. They build a super team now with LeBron and AD. It's like, you know, the NBA is boring to me. So it's, you know, it is what it is.
I think it's just people buying a championship. That's all it is. Like, how much can you spend to buy a championship?
Yeah. The super teams.
So Bushman's going to be with us at least for a segment. He said he's not able to go ahead and stay for the host show.
Listen, Charles, a lot has changed in 6 years. I have a family now. I have two kids. I have one on the way. So I have to make time for my family. And my wife has been working very hard at the hospital in the ICU. So she's now getting off of a 3-day shift. So she's got some time. I want to spend time with her. But I will be on for the next hour. And I'm actually looking up some connections, man.
Are you really gonna do the connections?
I'll bring out Lionel. I'll bring him out. We'll do some we'll bring out some misconnections. So I'm looking those up right now, buddy.
Got to get the ladies' man involved there. And so, yes. Just a little history again. 6 years ago, actually April 1st was the exact date of when we started.
It was, yeah.
It was an April Fool's thing. We did a couple of test shows, which didn't really count.
Nope.
And then Bushman comes on that show. I think it was either that show or the next week. And just talked about this one god-awful misconnection.
Oh, I remember that one. It was it was the Arby's kind of deal where she threw up in a certain orifice and it was
you can say it here. I mean, you may not be able to say it on your stream that you do, but you can
I can't say it on my stream. So I say that the person threw up in their vagina. It was just the weirdest Craigslist thing we've ever seen before, and it was the most hilarious thing to talk about on the show.
The subject was literally you threw my vagina.
Yeah, and what was cool about it was that place in time where when it's like a diamond in the rough where you catch it at the right time, and that misconnection was at the right time where we grabbed it and put it on the air. It was the most funniest thing
just amazing. In the world.
It was amazing. Yeah, is Matt coming on tomorrow's show?
Well, we don't have a show tomorrow. We have a show on Friday. And scheduled to be on. Like, he's been scheduled to be on other shows before, and you know Matt's schedule is more hectic than yours, believe it or not.
That's true. He's got like 8 kids, so yeah, I get it.
Yeah, he's got a baseball team.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I think there may be a little bit of a little bit of friction there, and I don't say that as a funny thing because
friction with you two.
No. Friction with the scheduling on Friday because
I got you.
His daughter kind of had a little.
I saw that she broke her arm. Yeah, that's terrible, man. That's
so I don't know if he's going to be needed at home or not, but that almost turned my stomach. Man.
Yeah, it was an ouch. Ugh.
Yeah. It's like watching. It's like watching a football play that you know this is done. He's done for the year.
It was like that Alex Smith injury a year and a half ago with the leg. So yeah. I hope his daughter gets well. Man, that's a terrible injury to have. I mean, I broke my wrist when I was a kid and it hurt like hell. But I can't imagine having her arm broken like that. I saw that, man. And,
I had to rub my arm just to make sure my bone was still all right. I mean, that just hurt looking at it. But yeah, all right, so we got Bushman on, and again, 6-year anniversary. This is night one. If you're not going to tune in for night one, which who knows if you are or not, night two will be Friday. And Friday, believe it or not, we actually have Mo coming in. We may have Mo and Nicole, they may actually be joining us for the Not So Newlywed game.
Okay.
So we have that on Friday. Matt is scheduled to be here, another one of the original founders. Have not found a way to get Matty Rock on. He's still stuck in the van. I have not heard from him in like 5 years. I tried to reach out to him, and it's like, well, I don't know how to do any of this shit. I'm thinking, well, Bushman can do it. You can do it.
There's a game for us. Where's Matty?
Yeah, where is Matt? Where in Pasco County
is Matty? Where in the world is Matty? Matty Rock.
He's in the van.
This guy got away. I don't. You know what? He's just too talented for me to be to co-host.
Who, Matty Rock?
You?
Oh, me? Oh.
You got the voices. You got the chops for it. And I'm saying that's why.
I appreciate that.
Yeah. Well, listen. I've always told you that. I always told you like you're the one that got away. So for tonight, what we have is we got a little segment from Bushman here. Bushman's going to go ahead and he says he's going to look up some misconnections that I didn't even know existed anymore.
No, they're still on there. I'm on there right now. I've been kind of sick the past couple of days, so my voice is going to be kind of weird trying to do that that voice. But
COVID?
No, not COVID. Just allergies, man. It's been kind of an ongoing.
Yep.
Thing.
Yeah, me days, too. So. Everybody.
I need to start selling shirts that just say "It's allergies, Karen. It's allergies."
So Lionel might be a little, his voice might be a little bit octave lower. So it'll be kind of interesting when I'm looking on here right now. I can't find any good ones yet. So I'm trying to find some good ones.
It's like they kind of dropped off the face of the earth. I don't know, man.
People actually use the misconnections section anymore.
I guess.
I mean, there's people posting on here. I'm going through all the cities in the state of Florida, and there's tons and tons of posts. I mean, I've found one that's got almost like a novel. So we might read that one. There's like a two paragraph. But the other ones are like, I saw you at like Starbucks. Can't call me or something like that. So that's
that's just like
that boring person and how many others. Boring. That's not specific enough.
No, that's not it. I found you at Starbucks. See how it is. That's the headline they use.
Yeah.
Hey, you were at Walmart. Who wasn't at Walmart? But you opened it up and says, well, you had some teared jeans in the ass crack, and I noticed you were wearing some low hangers and you had Johnson in the front. It's like, call me.
David, I told you to throw those away. Right.
David, I knew it was you. I just made one out of the blue. You really go ahead and made a misconnection out of that? Holy shit. Oh, God.
I really did just throw a pair of his jeans away when I did laundry, though, because they were just so torn up. It was like, you cannot wear these anymore.
Hold on. Wait. That's my air-conditioned jeans.
Yeah, well, they're gone.
Oh, damn it. Bye-bye air conditioner. We got a call,
Mexican
though.
Has them now.
Who do we got?
Happy anniversary from your numero uno fan.
Hey, Will. We don't hear him for like We don't hear from him 6 months to a year. All of a sudden, he's back-to-back shows.
He's back.
Yeah.
And I brought my friend with me from Virginia.
I thought it was a toy for a minute.
Who the hell is your friend from Virginia?
Charles.
Yeah, that's me.
My friend Roger is watching right now.
Roger. Well, hello, Roger.
Well, hello, Roger.
That's not the name of your blow up doll, is it?
Roger, why don't you go ahead?
No. Roger has the blow up doll though, and his blow up doll's name is Timmy.
Timmy Turner.
You know what? There's something weird about that.
Yeah.
But, so, you know, this does not sound like a real person. Walmart. This sounds like a blow up doll. Mm-hmm. It really does. Go ahead.
You guys mentioned Walmart. You know, there's really fun things to do at Walmart, like see how fast you can get kicked out,
or
Marco.
You can go hours. You can go hours.
You know what? He's actually right. So back in college, my friends would trip and go to Walmart. We would take bottles of cough medicine, drink them all, and then go and walk around Walmart like around midnight. That's an adventure when you're doing that, especially when they do a changeover at the registers and you're like tripping balls and you're trying to get out of there and your friend's tweaking out. So yeah, going and doing crazy things like that at Walmart is the best.
Sweet.
We played Marco Polo at Walmart.
Did you?
Marco Polo is always fun at Walmart.
I have not done the one thing that I wish I could do at Walmart, and that's the buggy races, car races.
I've done that.
How is it?
Karen's dad and I, because he was an older guy, obviously. And when he went, he had messed something up and he went and he had to use the cart. He did not like me.
Nope.
He didn't like me. So I would kind of sort of poke fun at him and I would get a cart too.
So you were an ass.
Yes. And I would get a cart.
Okay.
And we'd be going through the thing. And next thing I know, I'm getting slammed in the side. And he's like playing fucking bumper cars with these carts. So we're racing through the store, ramming each other with the carts.
Nice.
You guys are going to have to leave if you continue to do it.
What? How long after was it before you actually got asked to leave?
They didn't actually.
We never got asked.
Did you continue?
Fuck yeah, we did.
All right. I just want to make sure it's like you weren't wusses.
No.
Okay, good.
What's really great to do is when they start making announcements over the loudspeaker, you just drop to your knees, cover your ears, and start screaming, "Oh God, the voice is in my head."
Oh, that's great. That's freaking great.
or you go to the tower where they got all the balls. And you just grab the balls and start throwing. D3, don't be Kate anymore.
Oh my God.
We've ridden bicycles through Walmart before.
Skateboards. I've done the bicycle thing.
You got to get your ass down to Florida. We got to go to Walmart.
We did what do we call those things? The balls with the little handles to hop on?
Yeah. Yeah, the big bouncy balls.
Yeah, we hopped on those things all over Walmart. No, but we got Chase.
Chase or chafed?
They chase us.
Oh, they chase you.
We took all of the security guard and left.
You heard that too, Karen.
I did.
We thought you said you got chased.
Shorts were a little short that day. Went the wrong way.
Right, he's still talking. He's like, God, I love Will. Will's awesome. So what's up, man? What have you been up to?
What have I been up to?
Yeah.
Loving the fact that I get to rub in my future wife's face the fact that my Buccaneers knocked her Green Bay precious ugly Packers out of the playoffs.
Even though it was the quarterback you hate.
That's true. Right?
I don't care. I don't know who I hate more, Tom Brady or the Green Bay Packers. But I love my Buccaneers more than I hate both of them. So, hey.
Okay. Well.
We'll just go with that one.
Bush, let me ask you a question real quick. Or Evan, excuse me. I'm not sure you want to go by. But hearing this, Will is not a big Tom Brady fan.
Okay. But
supports the Buccaneers. Can you do one or the other? Or can you do both, I should say?
I mean, if you hate Tom Brady but support the Buccaneers, I mean, that's fine. I mean, as long as you support the team as a whole, that's fine. I mean, if I used to hate Tom Brady when he was with the Patriots, but now he's with the Buccaneers. But I love the guy because he brought a Super Bowl to Tampa Bay. But if you hate him still, but still support the team as a whole, that's quite all right. I mean, you can hate one and still love the other as long as you love the whole team as a whole. That's okay.
Okay. All right. I just want to make sure that we're we know you love the Buccaneers, but you also you don't love them 100%.
But I mean, Will, you should really love Tom Brady. I mean, it's the Tom Brady effect. As soon as he came down to Tampa Bay, everybody started to win. Lightning won the Stanley Cup. Rays are going the World Series. Everybody wants to come down and play for Tampa Bay, and now Tampa Bay's won it. A Lombardi Trophy. I mean, maybe you should. You have a little like to Tom Brady that since he's down here.
Now I'm going to get ridiculed by your guests because I live in Wisconsin, and the only thing I like about Tampa Bay is the Buccaneers.
Well, hold on. Excuse me. Number one, he's not just a guest. He is the original founding members of the show. So guess what? He trumps you.
Uh-oh.
I'm just telling you. He
trumps me by far.
But exactly.
As far as basketball goes, I'm a diehard Mavericks fan. Everybody knows that. And I love my Cubs and I love my Blackhawks. But, dude,
wait a second. This guy's from Wisconsin, loves the Dallas Mavericks, loves the Cubs, hates Tom Brady, loves the Buccaneers. Shouldn't this guy be like a Green Bay Packers fan and love Wisconsin all the way? What is this? What is this multi-state loving?
Oh, God. I hate the Packers with a passion in my belly. I can't stand that team.
What did they do to you?
Did they rip you off or something? Did Aaron Rodgers fuck you in the ass?
Did Brett Favre send you some nudes or something like that? Did he touch you in some wrong places? I don't get this multi-city, multi-state loving of different teams when you should be a diehard, you know, cheese state sports guy. I don't get it.
No. Okay, so let me tell you. My grandparents lived in Florida. They took me to my first football game. That's how I became a Buccaneer fan. Because my dad, may he rest in peace, is a Packer fan. My mom is a Bear fan, and I bounced between houses and who was in the same division at the time.
Oh, so what he's saying is he hates his dad because of the Green Bay Packers. That's why. Okay. We got to the root of the problem.
Just a good thing he didn't.
I almost became a Lions fan.
Just a good thing he didn't become a dancer and become one of those the Chris Farley Chippendales. We didn't want to see any of that. Just stay there. It's okay.
Growing up in Wisconsin, I got ridiculed from Packer fans from not being a Packer fan. Then from Bear fans, like, dude, seriously, we're just right over the border. You could at least root for us. And I'm like, no.
Right.
I'm a Buccaneer fan. Then going to Lambeau Field 2004, I got pegged by snowballs left and right by Packer fans. They escorted me out of the stadium halfway through the third quarter. Said, "You're being a distraction to other people that are watching the game."
So you got kicked out.
I'm not doing nothing but watching the game.
You got kicked out of a game, but didn't get kicked out of a Walmart. That's just saying something right there.
You know? I got kicked out of Lambeau Field for being dressed head to toe in Buccaneer gear.
Hey, I was ridiculed. I was ridiculed head to toe in the old sombrero when I was rooting for the Patriots when Bledsoe came into town right before the Bucs won their Super Bowl when they had All-Star. And believe me, I got I didn't get pegged, but my God, it was disastrous. I never will go to another opposing stadium again, ever.
Why would you do that? Well, at least if you go, don't dress in your team's clothes.
In 2004 as well. And I had Bear fans buying me beers.
Yeah.
Going, dude, you finally got a great team that you can be proud of. Have a beer. I'm like, I didn't get this treatment in Lambeau. That's because Packer fans are nothing but a bunch of dicks.
Well, Bears fans, are they just still right next? Man.
Hey, wait a second Patty. I live with a family. No, let me rephrase that. Alyssa's family's Bear fans.
Okay.
So let's not go there now.
Well, all right. I just know when I used to watch the Bears, it was a lot of redneck fans.
Well, that may be back in the day when the Bears
were good.
Yeah, when they were back in the 30s when they won Super Bowl, NFL 80s. Championships.
They were good in the 80s.
No, they were okay in the 80s. Ooh, somebody was cheering. And it was not Stefan, I can tell you that much. That could be one of Bush's bunch. Bush's bunch. There we go.
What's up? The screaming in the background? Yeah, that's one of my kids.
All right.
It's like a common sound at this time of day.
Yeah,
it is. It's bedtime.
I'm reading the private chat. If you need to do what you got to do, Mr. Dad, I understand. I just appreciate you stepping on.
I would love to do the missed connections because I've got four of them ready to go, and they're pretty good.
Well, I'll tell you what. If you need to handle things now, we're until 9. If you want to jump back on a little later and pick it up, you can.
Okay.
All right. We'll do that.
All right. I'll be back in a little bit.
All right. We're going to go ahead and say adios to Bushman. And here we go. We're back. Karen, I want to say, hey, welcome to the show. It says happy anniversary. Roger says hi as well. And Jeff's on there. Okay. So, Will, now that the Tampa Bay – buddy over here is not going to pick on you anymore. What do you want to say?
Nothing, man. I'm just so proud of you. Like living out one of your dreams, man. One of your, you know, dreams, just doing what you love to do for 6 years, man. I'm very happy of you. I'm very proud of you, man.
Well, I appreciate it. I wish this would have been 6 years of maybe getting paid, getting on FM radio or maybe, you know, doing something like that. But
yeah, this free shit, man.
Yeah. This free shit's, you know, just
the fuck.
Shut up.
Hey, who knows? 2-3 years down the line, You never know what's going to happen, man.
I'm over here just thinking if it hasn't happened going. If it hasn't happened in 6 years, I don't think it's happening. I mean, I think believe me, I put on some good shows that I was like, yeah, this sounds really good, and it's not being heard, and it's just whatever.
So look how long it took Howard Stern to get to New York.
Well, but he was getting paid, and he also graduated college, and you know, he had a. He took a different path than I was, and also he was like really horny and Jewish. So that's just two things that don't happen with me now.
Well, I'm horny.
Well, you're not Jewish.
No. You're I'm not country. Jewish you're, either. You're, so I can't you're
horny
help
you. And country.
Horny and country.
Yeah.
So my friend messages me and she goes, I'm gonna request that you do a special time one night. I didn't know what she was talking about.
Special time.
Right?
Is she really wanting you to get down there? I don't, she wanted you to get down and dirty.
Well, who's this? Hello.
Hey, listen.
Christy. So I said, she goes, hello. She says, after I get these assholes to bed.
I want you to do a special time on me. Just one time. That's it. One time and go. So just don't even look at me when you're done. Just go.
I scrolled to see what the conversation was. Maybe like, what did I say? I sent her the show.
TikTok.
And she never gets to watch the show like when we're live, and she wants to talk shit. So.
Oh, she wants to talk shit.
Yeah.
Oh, what is her fucking number? I'll get her on the phone.
She's putting assholes to bed.
You know what I want to see happen on the show?
What do you want to see happen?
I want to see Charles roast the hell out of Peter.
Ooh.
I've already done that.
Yeah, he roasted him for like 45 minutes.
No, to Peter's face. I want to see you do it to his face.
He's
on the
too
show.
He's too pussy to even come on
the
show.
Yeah, he's not going to come on the show.
Let me ask you this. I even asked Peter to come on the show to promote his show, to actually talk a little bit here.
He could not do it.
He wouldn't want to. Oh, I already get promotion.
Who's Peter?
Exactly.
You missed that when you were working.
Yeah. This guy used to be on Bucks Report, or is on Bucks Report. He's the face of Bucks Report, and that's why they're not really going anywhere, because he's the face of Bucks Report. Not to say I'm going to do any better. I'm just saying I don't claim to be a Mr. Frickin' Know-It-All or the greatest of all time or the pinnacle of sports talk television. Giving you something to think about. Thinking about how stupid I sound. That's what you get to think about. But I'm just saying, it's
man, keep up everything you're doing, man. I'm so proud of you.
Well, I appreciate it. Thank you very much. And hopefully one of these days we'll get paid and we'll go get together. Have a drink.
Hopefully I'll be here Friday. Excuse me. Ooh, frog.
Well, listen.
Hopefully I'll see you on Friday as well.
I think it's what, 2-3 shows in a row you've called in? Come on, you can't break your streak now.
Keep that blow up doll out of your mouth when you're talking.
Right, exactly.
Roger has the blow up doll. I told you guys that.
Well, hold on a minute. Is it? Wait.
Roger.
Is it Roger the alien dude on fucking Family Guy?
Yes. Yes, he's got a fucking alien living up there in Wisconsin.
I see what's going on now.
I fucking see it now. Now I get it.
You're fucking covering up something. Oh,
Roger, they're calling you an alien now, dude.
Bullshit.
How big is your tentacle?
Oh my God. Well, if you ever take a look at Roger, he's basically a cross-dresser between male and female. I don't even know who it is.
I don't know.
He's got a Roger. He's got a
he's
male
a trans
name.
Alien.
Trans alien. Listen, nowadays you can't say that. You have to be binary.
Okay,
so binary
you are
alien.
A male alien.
He's a bino
or
alien.
A male or female alien.
Boys have a penis. Girls have a vagina.
Well, what do you do if you have both?
Well, then you thank the plastic surgeon that gave you the other one.
Do you want what's swinging or what's wet? Which one?
Then you're probably in Jeff Anderson's playlist on Pornhub. I'm just saying.
The pole or the hole?
Right, the pole or the hole. There we go. That's a good one.
If you want the hole, I got to tuck the other one real quick.
Oh, my God. You know what? And all this right here, just it sinks into reality. And I'm thinking, thank God I don't have to date anymore. Thank God I don't have to ask the question. What species were you born as, male or female?
Okay, you don't
that's
have to
like
date
that,
anymore.
Hold on a minute. That's like that old guy that was on America's Got Talent.
Yeah,
and he was singing about going and meeting this chick in a bar, and he took her home, and he started feeling her up, and he reached between her legs to have a little fun with her and found out that she's got a Johnson bigger than his.
Do you realize Funky Cold Medina did the same thing? Mm-hmm. Took a girl home, got undressed. Sheena was a man.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, that's apparently it's been going on since the 80s, but it's not as like, it's not as advanced as it was back then. They're not calling for other type of identification.
Well, what do you think life is like for swingers right now?
Depends on what you're swinging.
You got to screen everybody.
Yeah.
Right?
I mean, I think
so. You have a vagina?
Listen, I got a couple of questions here. Do you like it nasty? Do you go ahead and are you a squirter? And number three, do you have a penis or a vagina? Do you imagine that conversation?
My name is Angela. What do you think? Was it once Angelo?
Yeah. Was it once Andy? What was your birth name?
Let me see the bottom of your boot.
Then your my name is Kelly. What do you think?
Kelly with an I or Kelly with a Y?
Tony said it could be a swinging
name. Exactly.
I'm just saying, awkward. It's a little awkward. You know, go ahead and talk about that.
You know you're fucked when you got when you meet somebody that hurt, but that the name was Angel.
Yeah,
that can literally swing both
that
ways.
That is true. What other names can swing both ways? That's actually a good topic.
Terry
can swing both ways.
Joe.
Yeah, Joe.
Like Joe.
Yeah. Joe. But Joe sounds too masculine. I know I shouldn't use that word masculine because we're not supposed to do that anymore. I could get a big fine, but of course, Tony has to chime in with that. Could be a swinging D.
Pat.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. Well, first off, anybody goes ahead and names their kid Pat. It either needs to be Patricia or Patrick. Name your kid Pat, you're gay.
It normally is, but then they shorten it.
That reminds me of the old SNL skit.
Yeah,
it's Pat.
Did we ever find out what she was? Actually, it was portrayed with a she actress. So I would guess it would have to be female.
My biological mother's name was Patricia, and I called her my Pat.
I don't know why.
And she went by Pat.
She went by Patty.
No, she went by Pat.
Peppermint Patty, which we don't even know if she's a male or female. That's another thing. It's like
part of the penis character. Those are strong to suck on, so maybe it's a guy.
Hold on a minute. Yeah. What? Makes you wonder. Patty cake?
Baker's man. Not Baker's she-man or whatever.
Are we allowed to say those nursery rhymes?
We can't do it anymore. We're all going to get in trouble. We all have to censor ourselves. Oh. I'm actually surprised I'm not already censored on Facebook.
Right.
For saying male, female, boy, girl.
I'm in Facebook jail half the time.
You in Facebook jail? You're like an innocent like a fish. How can you be in Facebook jail?
You being in Facebook jail. I'm surprised you're not.
Oh, no. I know what to say and how to say it and when to say it.
Yeah, but I sometimes tend to post things on your page so that I don't get in trouble on mine. Just saying.
You asshole. Okay, well, I know who to basically take off his administrative rights then. I know that. All right. I see how that works.
See, I don't post shit.
Yes, you do.
No, what do you mean you don't post shit? Not to the
Charles Richardson page.
Oh yeah, he doesn't do anything.
Actually,
he doesn't
do
work
anything
on
anywhere.
No, I don't. I just said that.
He's barely a part of the show.
Oh.
I do everything on his business.
You know, you don't
go
Mo,
back to being quiet.
You know, Mo actually posts more than David's done.
That's
ever?
True. That's true. I will give just him. Saying. I will give him credit.
Fine, I'm fucking leaving.
No, shut up.
I will Sit give him credit. Down. He usually sends it to me.
You guys,
he usually sends it to me, and then I post it. So I'll give him some credit.
He sends it to you, and you post it.
Yeah.
Well, you know what you got to do every time he sends you something. You have to say it's from David.
From David. You know why he does that, though? Do you know why he does that?
Why?
A pussy.
My penis is too small. I'm scared. What's going to happen? You got the bigger one. You post it.
Let me inform you of something.
Yes.
We're waiting. Hello.
I'm sorry.
Let me tell you.
David.
Let me tell you something. Hello.
Hello.
Are you still there?
Me? Yeah, I'm here.
Are you trying to check to see if it's still there?
It's not.
He's got to be.
You keep saying my balls are in your purse.
You had it with a jar of formaldehyde in your purse.
Hello, David. Are you still there? he fell asleep. He's like saying, "Let me tell you something. I'm going to go ahead and
I'm going to haul off and leave you alone."
Don't threaten
me. Don't threaten me with a good time. Here and act like I'm tough. That's what I'm.
That's
all
right. That's all right.
Microphone tough guy.
We had actually earlier in the week his allergies were killing
him. How about that?
So I gave him medication that I normally take.
Opera, how about that?
It treats allergies. So I gave David these capsules I said, "How long has it been since you took the last one?" He goes, "Almost 5 hours." So I said, "Okay, well, you can take another one." Now this went on for like 2 days. And then he's at the end of
Monday and Tuesday.
Close to the second end of the second day, he goes, "I cannot stay awake. I do not know what's wrong with me." I said, "Well, you're taking those allergy pills." He goes, "But still," he goes, "Benadryl doesn't knock me out like this." And he was going in and out, sleeping, having this conversation. And when he woke up, I told him, I said, "You know, those are the pills that I take for sleeping pills. That's what they were prescribed to me for. Mm-hmm. But they also treat allergies." He goes, "So you've been drugging me for 2 days."
Those whole 2 days, I couldn't remember a damn thing.
He couldn't.
It's like, you gotta stay off the drugs, dude.
He
swear to God.
Stay awake for nothing.
It's like, "You spent $1 million yesterday." "No, I didn't."
Accidentally, maybe. Oh, we got Bushman back on. He actually is.
Bushman's
looks like
back
he
sit there and criticize me being for a Cubs fan.
Oh, shut up. Thanks for calling, Will. We gotta leave you go now.
I usually do the thing with Benadryl where I take two and then I slowly start to fall asleep, but I catch myself before falling asleep and then I try to jerk off before I fall asleep with the Benadryl. And then you catch a sense of euphoria when that happens. It's really weird. I'm just kidding, by the way. So,
oh, damn. I was going home. I
was about ready to go ahead and actually get that. Get the Benadryl.
We call that.
Let's take it a bit further. Let's get some Seroquel.
This is a DIY on how to have pleasure.
Hey, I all right.
Without a blow up, though. Oh my God! You know what? We're gonna have
Roger. You may need to step aside now.
We're gonna have to merge calls here because Tony D's coming on right now. Oh my God! It's a party in the house. Swinging D and Will.
Yes, I'm here to swing my D all over your face.
Well, you're gonna have to. You better have a long D coming across like maybe five or six states. That ain't happening from up there.
I got a six stater here.
Yeah, right.
You just backed the fuck up.
What's up, Tony?
You know, man, the biggest joke in the NFL, the team right now is my team. And the Eagles are literally, I have no idea what the fuck is going on in Philly. But we traded our sixth pick to go to the 12th pick. And we are literally giving up on this tight end. That's coming out of Florida State right now.
Kyle Trask.
Florida?
Kyle Trask.
What's his name?
Kyle Trask.
Yes. And we are literally giving up on this kid. This kid's going to go in the first.
Wait a second. You guys don't even need a tight end. You have Dallas Goedert right there. I mean, he was a pretty good tight end for you guys last year. Your team is such a mess right now where you're even looking to draft a quarterback. You brought over what, Joe Flacco to be the backup for Jalen Hurts. It seems like Jeffrey Lurie has had a stroke one too many times and is just doing the dumbest shit ever with your team. Not to mention the fact that Philadelphia Eagles fans are the worst people out there in the world. They have the worst fan base and are the worst people. When you punch horses and eat your own feces, that's a problem with your whole city and your whole state is when your fans are like that.
Wasn't that the best video though?
If you Eagles fans consider that the best thing in the world, that's your deal. The Eagles are a mess. They are probably one of the laughing stocks of the league right now. And I would say this, the Jets are no longer the laughing stock. The Eagles are. The Jets actually have a plan in place to get better. The Eagles have said, "Hey, maybe we'll take a play out of the Jets playbook and be the worst team in the league right now."
Wouldn't it be amazing though if they went ahead and made the playoffs?
Let's be honest here, Bushman. The only reason the Jets, if the Eagles would have stuck foot with Joe Douglas and got rid of Howie Roseman, the Eagles would have been in a better position. When the Jets got Joe Douglas, they got a guy that was a football guy. Howie Roseman has no idea what he's doing. That's the difference here. Joe Douglas is building a franchise while Howie Roseman is destroying a franchise. I mean, the Eagles were the pinnacle of the East of the NFC East for a long, long time. I mean, we had our battles with the Bucks, and the Bucks always won, and that was true. But
the NFC East should be docked playoffs for 1 year because of the worst division in the league. Any team from the NFC East should not go to the playoffs next year at all. Like, you guys shouldn't be allowed to play.
I agree, but Washington has a strong team next year, though, dude. Washington's don't have a strong team.
They don't have a team name. How can they have a strong team?
The Washington football team is going to go back to the playoffs with Taylor Heineke as their quarterback? I don't think so, bro. Come on. They've got a strong defense, and that's pretty much it.
They're going to go back there with Ryan Fitzpatrick. That's who they're going to
go back with. Yeah, they got Ryan Fitzpatrick now. Which, again, I think he lasts six games, and that's it.
I love talking sports. I saw the Tampa Bay. I heard the sports talk under Charles Lake Sports. I was like, fucking ain't right. You know what? Take away the Tony D show. Let's talk some fucking sports, man. Like I'm down. Like, I'm game. Like, let's talk that shit. Like,
I will admit something. I did say the wrong owner of the Philadelphia Eagles, by the way. I said the wrong owner name. I was thinking of the Miami Marlins. I had a brain fart there for a second. It's all the cold medicine I'm on right now. I did take two Benadryl, so I might be doing that trick there.
When you go ahead and see Bushman start to go ahead and doze off, just remember that's like the moment he's about ready to jerk off.
Yep.
Yeah, that's true. That's a good point. Thanks, Charles.
You said the right name. You said the right
name. Okay. Okay.
You said Jeffrey Lurie.
Okay. See, he's not even sure if he's wrong or right.
Yeah, you said Jeffrey Lurie.
All right.
Didn't the Eagles try and get Adam Gase somehow on their coaching staff? I'm just curious.
Why would you?
I don't know.
If they're trying to tank that bad, might as well.
The Eagles are in such a bad shape right now. The whole coaching staff is the first year coaching staff coming in under all their positions. You got Jalen Hurts, who they keep saying that they're going to trade this guy. Then they want to draft a quarterback. They got rid of pretty much their whole friggin' team. Your wide receiver core is nothing now. I mean, this team went from winning the Super Bowl in 2017 in 3 years being absolutely ass, like complete ass. And Tom Brady's still out here throwing bombs. Like, there's a problem. There's a problem.
No,
man.
See, Tom Brady's throwing bombs to actual legitimate Hall of Fame all-star receivers, where he didn't have that before.
If you want to talk about the NBA being a joke, the NFL is turning into a joke.
What?
The NFL's doing the same shit.
Well, hold on a second. Let's take his analysis, because when the Buccaneers were piling up, what were they doing? They were piling up on all this talent. No, they weren't spending more money than the cap was, but they were finding all this talent. They were loading up on everything. So, yeah, they were basically going, we're all in on this year. It's either if we don't get a Super Bowl victory, if we don't get a Super Bowl, it's a failure. So I kind of see where he's going, but the baseball and basketball, they just spend obscene amounts of money. They buy their championships. They buy the chip.
In basketball, if you really want to be honest, all you need is like 6-7 guys, and then just put some like 7-foot center from Lithuania, grab some guy hauling garbage, be like, hey, you're in good shape. Why don't you come over here and just sit on the bench? We'll give you a jersey.
I'm a little confused there, because number one, nobody, not even the Lakers, have 7 all-star talented guys. They may have 4, but nobody's going to have 7. So no, what you're asking for is impossible.
What I'm saying is you really need to just focus on getting 7 players. You get like 3, maybe 4 all-stars. You get the other 3 guys that are like, you know, key players that can like fill the hole, and then just fill the rest of the roster with garbage. It doesn't matter.
Cool. Everybody agree with Will, right? Let's just fill the roster with garbage.
I don't know where we went with this conversation.
I don't know. Well,
I got lost.
Yeah. Listen. I think Will got taken on some Benadryl as well, and he's talking a little crazy. So
I'm actually going to go ahead and say adios to Will. So, Will, thank you again for calling in. Man. We'll hopefully talk to you Friday. All right.
Bye-bye.
All right. Take care. All right. We'll continue this conversation with maybe something other than sports with Tony D and Bush. I don't know. That's yeah, let's go ahead and fill the lineup with garbage. Let's do that. Makes no sense.
Well, what do you want to talk about? What do you want to talk about?
What do you mean, what do I want to talk about?
You want to talk about that fuck-faced Tom Gulley?
I think I don't think Bush knows about Tom Gulley. And, you know, he's a special co-host tonight. So we'll stay off the Tom Gulley talk until next week. But we got we got Bush tonight. He's going to probably get into the misconceptions here in a little bit. We may take a break here shortly, get that out of the way, and we'll see.
Well, Bush, let me ask you, where can I find your stuff at? Is it on Spotify?
Yeah, you can go on Spotify and Apple Podcasts and look up Play the Bay, and you could also go to Believe.com. It's B-L-E-A-V. And B-L-E-A-V as Believe.com.
I believe it.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah. Now, do you talk just nothing but Florida sports, or do you do national sports?
We primarily talk about the Bucks, the Rays, and the Lightning, but we do throw in the national stuff here and there. So, yeah, I mean, we talk about it, but yeah.
You guys doing any Final Four talk?
We did a couple weeks ago. We talked about it. I know coming up in the next couple weeks, we will be talking about the NFL draft, which is coming up, and then also, of course, baseball is starting tomorrow. Happy opening day to everybody. So that's what we've got on the docket, too, as well.
Cool. Very cool.
So Jacksonville, what do you think? Jacksonville's taking Lawrence first?
Oh, definitely. If they don't take Trevor Lawrence, I mean, unless you're going to go after Mac Jones, Trevor Lawrence has got to be a lock for them. I think he's going to fit well with Urban Meyer's system and everything like that. I mean, obviously the Jacksonville Jaguars are in rebuilding mode for the next few years, so if Lawrence is their guy, which, you know, they've kind of pointed to, it's something to build around, and hopefully Urban Meyer can get it done. Obviously we all know Urban Meyer is a great college football coach, even though he likes to stick around for only a couple of years until something happens and he has to jump ship, you know, take a leave of absence for about a year, then come back to the fold like he has before. So we'll see how long he stays in the NFL. I mean, he does have a weak heart, so we'll see how it goes. But yeah, I think it's going to be a consensus number one pick will be Trevor Lawrence going to the Jacksonville.
I think the incarnation of the first start where Pete Carroll came in, he went for a couple of years, then went back to college. I think that's where we see Urban Meyer.
You think so? I mean, yeah. Pete Carroll has had so much success in the NFL after he left USC. I mean, he's won a Super Bowl with Seattle, and every single year the Seattle, you know, Seahawks go to the playoffs. So
yeah, he has to get his dick wet in the NFL, yeah, and then go back.
Obviously he's not going to pull Nick Saban and quit after like a few weeks. Obviously he won't do that.
That's
so
shocking to me too, man. Because I feel like Saban would be all right in the NFL if he just got with the right team.
Listen, Saban is—he's a college guy. He's gonna be—he's gonna go to the Hall of Fame for coaches. I mean, he's gonna be the most winningest coach in all of football, for college football. I think Urban Meyer has maybe always hinted he wants to go to the NFL, and this is his chance. And he's got a lot to prove. I mean, he's really got a lot to prove with a shitty team. So, he's got a lot of work ahead of him.
What's your guys' take on the 17th season now?
I hate it.
The
reason why I hate it, while Bush thinks about it, is because it's an odd number of games. It's not. It's somebody's playing one more road game. The other teams are playing one more home game. It's not fair.
I agree, Charles, with you a little bit, and I also it's you know, to me it's more of a cash grab for the NFL. They want to get more money out of the TV and the advertising. You know, I know
18 games like the CFL.
I know a lot of the players are really unhappy with having the 17 games. Obviously, it takes away one of the preseason games and adds another regular season game, which we all hate preseason. Let's be honest, preseason is the worst thing at all. I mean, so. I mean, honestly, it helps with fantasy football for championships. That I like more football, just like any other guy around here. So, I mean, having another game for the regular season is okay with me. It pushes back, though, the Super Bowl another week, which now will fall on February 13th now instead of the first week of February. So,
well, my thing is, if it's still 20 games, three preseason, 17 regular season with a one bye week, Why would it push it back unless they're starting later?
They are that's what it said today. They are pushing the Super Bowl back another week. So
interesting.
Yeah. I'm not going to complain about not having more football. I mean, I think the players have more of a say about, you know, not wanting to play a 17th week. But to me, it's more football for me to watch and more football for me to bet on.
My thing is it's another week of possible injury. You know what I mean?
That's the same way you can look at preseason games.
Yeah, exactly. And Charles, you're right. It's the same thing with preseason. You guys got guys playing four useless games where guys that are starters could get hurt in preseason. So what's the difference of them getting hurt in preseason than they could in that last, you know, game of the year? You know what I mean?
And I mean, if you take a look at the last year they had no preseason games, but I think you saw the quality of football start to improve after maybe just a couple of weeks, maybe three, but at least 2 weeks, I think that's all you really need.
Right.
And you could do the OTAs just all like you did last year.
So over under, and this is a Philly question. I know you guys, you know, hate
that's,
Philly.
That's under. Like,
but Carson Wentz wins the Super Bowl before the Eagles even make the playoffs again.
I agree. No. You know what? Let's fine tune that. Let's say Carson Wentz goes to the playoffs before the Eagles do again.
Carson Wentz goes to the playoffs before the Eagles have another winning season.
Or you could go Carson Wentz gets an MVP before the Eagles make the playoffs again.
How about Carson Wentz dies before the Eagles make the Super Bowl?
That's morbid.
We could do that. That's real morbid.
I
wish nothing but Carson all the luck in the world. Him going back, him going and reuniting with Frank Wright is great. He's going into a great system in Indianapolis. They've got a great team, lots of talent, great offensive line, great defense, a lot of weapons he's got. So I think Carson, it's pretty much for him to fail is for him to screw up royally, and hopefully they can recapture that magic like they did a few years ago with him and Frank Wright. I think it's going to be a match made in heaven with those two teams, with those two guys together on the Colts.
Yeah, I'm kind of anxious to see what's going
to
happen.
To be honest with you, as a Wentz guy, like I was a Wentz guy, I wasn't a Foles guy. Like I like Foles for winning us Super Bowl, but he wasn't the answer for the long term. But as a Wentz guy, this dude is going to throw numbers, and I want nothing more but him to be successful in Indianapolis and then throw back in Philly's face and say, "You fucked up." I can't say that because
listen, if you being a true Philly fan, would you rather see Carson Wentz on the field for 10 games and injured for six, or in this case, seven, and have the backup go into the playoffs, or would you rather see somebody that actually can finish a full season? Because see, that's why they gave up by once, because he was injury prone.
Yeah, but
they couldn't keep him healthy.
But the moral of it is, Charles, is that Wentz is capable of being an elite quarterback in the NFL. He has already proven
with
that
the tools around him. With the tools around him, and we're going to find out because he has the tools now.
And he had the tools in 2017.
He did. And he had 14 and 1 or something before he got hurt?
I think he was 36 touchdowns and 5 picks.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was going to be the MVP of that year if he didn't get hurt. Yeah.
He was amazing.
He was amazing that year.
I mean, he was so what happened was he got hurt, and then all of a sudden Nick Foles comes in, wins a Super Bowl for him. Now all of a sudden he's in his head because he's got this guy next to him. And then the Eagles stupidly draft Jalen Hurts. Foles, you know, walks out and goes to Jacksonville. They draft Jalen Hurts. And now all of a sudden he's watching over his shoulders. He wasn't himself last year. We could all say that as Eagles fans. He wasn't himself. He's going to go out there with Frank Wright. And Frank Wright is going to put him back to 2017. And I'm telling you, this dude is going to throw numbers next year. And if you got him on your fantasy, you might as well just grab him now, because everyone is like, oh, no, he can't stay healthy. He can't stay healthy. Listen, I have a strong gut feeling with that offensive line that he's just walking into in Indianapolis. This dude's going to be A-OK, and the numbers are going to be through the roof.
Listen, if I was a fantasy football manager, I would draft Carson late as a backup, and have him just stash there until like your starter goes down, or if you have a bye week you need to fill in. He's going to do well. He's going to put up, I wouldn't say MVP numbers in Indianapolis, but he's going to have a good, I think he's going to have a good season with the Colts.
Yep, I do. Tony, we got to go ahead and move things along here, man. We appreciate you calling. Don't forget, call on Friday because you're on a roll.
And Tony, we're on every Tuesday night, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, streaming live on YouTube and also on Twitch.
Cool. There you go.
All right, brother. I'll take you out. Good talking to you, Bushman. Good talking to you, Charles, Karen, and my good friend, Big Old David.
What about Alyssa? You didn't say hi to Alyssa.
I'm not watching the fucking camera, Charles, so I didn't see her walk in.
What type of fan are you?
He's an Eagles fan. What do you expect?
All right, Tony.
Roll talk.
All right. Bye. Jesus Christ.
I have to apologize to Alyssa because I did not say hello to Alyssa as well. Hello, Alyssa.
Well, I didn't put her on camera yet because
nobody knew I was here.
We were talking football.
I had nothing to say. I was falling asleep.
Yeah, she was falling asleep. I didn't want to put her on camera.
I gotcha.
So that's all good. All right, so... Misconnections. Do I have any sexy music to play?
Yeah, I was gonna say, do you have that porn music you used to play?
Yeah, I finally got done wrestling the Velociraptor. He's in bed.
Okay, good. Yeah. Let me pull up Virtual DJ. Was not prepared for misconnections, although I love misconnections. Don't get me wrong.
I've got five.
Honey, did you drink like 3 liters of caffeine today or something? Because you are literally bouncing over there.
I am, because I was basically up to the last minute of going on the air. I was figuring shit out. So it was not pretty. Instrumentals.
I mean, I can go. Tell me something good.
That's not it.
That's you can't. You can't make babies with that. You can't. That's clubbing music. That's not baby making music. Come on. Oh, shit. How about this? I mean, obviously you'll be making babies afterwards after the club. But...
No, let's try something else.
That's like some slow R&B stuff. Oh, hey, girl. Hey.
All right, here we go.
Hey, how you doing? Hey, Charles, it's been a long time. How you doing?
Hey, I'm doing good, ladies man. How you been?
I've been so good. I've been living in Miami for the past 5-6 years, so it's been going good. I've been living on the beach. Yes, the beach itself. I don't have a home. I'm actually homeless. I've been living on the beach.
Well, listen, with all the corona going on, man, I'm sure you probably lost your job of doing.
Well, you know, no, obviously business has been slow, but since we live in a state where our governor's name is Death Santis, business has been pretty good, especially down in the Miami area where nobody gives a flying shit. So it's all good. Yeah, it is all good. So I'm glad to be back. It's been a very long time. So we're going to go through some myth connections. And my first one, it really hits it out of the park. It's titled Latin Male Looking for Male Friends in Oxford and Summerfield, which is in Georgia somewhere. So this one's short and sweet. It goes, young bottom Latin guy looking for a top. Come and chill. Have a drink, watch a movie, and just chill. And for all you guys that don't know what a bottom is, it means gay sex. That's all it means. It's gay sex. Yes. Okay.
That's all it was. Just
pretty much sex. It just says it for itself. Okay. Right. So this next one is Mitch at the vitamin shop. Now, if anybody's trying to have a misconnection at the vitamin shop, I'm there. Okay. Give me some creatine. Just stick it in my booty and then we're all ready to go. Okay. I'll get some steroids. We'll get all roided out. It's all nice. Okay.
So horny goat weed.
Yeah, it's a horny goat weed. Yeah, that milk thistle too. All right, now get your strong like bull. Okay. So Friday, March 19th, this guy actually has the date on this. Friday 3/19 on the evening, which was the evening of that night, I guess, said, no, my name's not Mitch, but I've been mistaken for a David. And even Eric Church, whoever Eric Church is, he's been also mistaken for David and Mitch. But this guy's not named Mitch. His name is David or Mitch, or I don't know what his name is now. Perhaps I could get your name and we could have lunch together. I guess his name is David. From me. But he says he's Mitch at the vitamin shop, but his name is not Mitch. So I'm confused if he's David or Eric Church. So he must have
at the vitamin shop.
Yeah, I think he's gender confused already.
He might have three personalities competing for for one lady, or maybe one gentleman. I don't even know. Exactly. Perhaps I could get your name and we could have lunch together at your convenience. You're rather easy on the eyes, quite attractive you are. I'm no landscaper, but you've got a nice backyard. Oh, that's a pickup. I don't know what it is. See, now here's where it takes kind of a creepy turn. It goes, I'm driving a white van. What are you driving? Now, see, if you're trying to hook up with anybody, don't get in their white vans, because white vans usually have no windows, which means you're probably going to get tied up and get raped. So, yes, don't go with Mitch, David, or Eric Church, because you might get raped. Okay.
Unless you have a rape fantasy, and maybe that's what you need.
Well, unless you bring unless you bring like a lawnmower or a weed whacker or an edge trimmer.
He says
he's no landscaper because I guess he has he likes to do things with lawns or something like
David
that.
David says he likes a lot of people's landscaping.
Yes. Okay. He likes big bushes for some reason. I don't know.
He likes big bush. We cannot lie.
Yes. Okay. So this next one is top for use. Okay. We're going back to the top stuff now. Okay. So top to help out uncut and hairy. So I'm gonna start off with that. It says top to help out uncut and hairy. Drop me a note with location and stats. Need you to host. Now this could be for a variety of things. This could be a haircut party. This could be a wall. This could be a back waxing party. This could be a bikini waxing, or it could just mean straight up guy on guy hairiness. So that's what it could mean. He's uncut. He's hairy. He just want to get somebody to host his pest party or something like that. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not sure it's going to be a party, but it ain't going to be a haircutting party.
It'll be something. He's got a big bush, I guess. I don't know. So this next one is married guy needs friend. I'm 50 years old. I'm a straight white male in a sexless marriage. I need a friend to go to in the mornings to get service on semi-regular basis. Anyone? ? Dot dot dot. I'm so sorry for this.
Yeah, guy. I wonder. I know what the service means.
Yeah, he needs a landscaper. He needs a landscaper.
He needs a landscaper. He needs somebody to change his oil.
Yes,
I get it.
I feel sorry. He doesn't name his name. I feel sorry for this gentleman. He's in a sexless marriage. I feel sorry for him. That's why.
50 years old. Yes. That doesn't give any contact information. Then we can go ahead and.
No. He just lives in 309. He lives in Gainesville somewhere, and in Gainesville, it's just cow pastures and weeds. So he's not having a good time with cows and weed. I think he's
going to bestiality if that's the case.
Well, I mean, they've got nice udders. I mean, I'm not saying I haven't done bestiality before, but geez, cows are very attractive.
Or cow tipping.
Yeah, that's right. Man.
I'll be underneath a cow sometimes. Okay, next we've got Judy Williams from Hampton. Hampton is somewhere in Gainesville, another one in Gainesville. I'm looking for an old friend. Her name was Judy Williams and lived in Hampton. We went to SCF in the late 70s, but she got distracted. We lost touch. Last I knew, she was seeing some guy named Bubba or something like that. Judy graduated from... This is like a huge biography. What the hell is wrong with this lady? Just get right to the point. I want to get with Judy. That's it. Jesus, lady, come on now. Jesus.
Right?
Right? If we don't care about your mind, we just care about your body.
Yes, exactly. Maybe she should talk to Eric Church or Mitch or somebody. Jeez, or that guy that's in a sexless marriage or whatever. Okay. This next one, and this was I was talking about earlier, or Evan was talking about earlier. It's the two paragraphers, so hold on to your hats. This one's going to be a long one, okay? This is Stacy Tradewinds Lounge, Thursday night, 325. So this is recent. This was last week, and this is in St. Augustine. All right, here we go. Hey, need some help, please! ! I need this. I know this is a long shot. Met a really nice woman at the Tradewinds Lounge, 124, that she gives out the goddamn address for this place. God, geez. On Thursday, 325-21 in the historic part of St. Augustine, corner place by the lines. Nobody needs... Just put the address on there and tell them where it's at. Jeez.
Just put, you know, the...
It's not run by.
We need the coordinates. Yeah, it's exactly not.
It's
where
not.
It is.
It's not run by Facebook. You can go and put the address. They're not going to block you.
Yep.
Okay. See, with a decent sized group of guy and girlfriends, 10 or so, ages. How does they know that your age approximately 40 to 50? This guy should be a profiler for the police. Maybe he'll find Stacy that way. Name is Stacy. Not sure of the spelling. Whether you can only spell Stacy probably three ways. Okay, so Stacy, S-T-A-C-Y kind of narrows it down a lot. Blonde hair and a ponytail, lives up outside of Jacksonville somewhere, she told me. If you know her or happen to see her, please reach out. I'd like to talk to you again. Just talk and see where it goes. Worst case, we both make a new friend. Seemed like a lot of fun. Okay. And then he seemed, oh my God, he just repeats himself. I know this is a long shot in the dark, which you said in the first paragraph, but I believe in people meeting for a reason. So I have to take a shot, another shot, and try to get in touch with you. Take a shot every time this guy says shot. And that would be a nice drinking. Please. You were friends with John. Pretty sure you're just a friend with John. He's pretty sure about a lot of things in this.
Look, sounds okay? Like 10 Second Tom.
Oh my goodness! You said he previously lived in my fucked up state. Which state am I from? Ha ha! If you see this place, take a chance and message me. There's nothing to lose. I'm trying not to change anything, and anything's in real capital letters. Anything
you in your life.
I'm looking to get to know you. Nothing more. It was great meeting you. Hoping to see you this week and wish to talk to you again. If you happen to know her, please send her a link to this post. Thank you. And that is unknown from St. Augustine. Look for Tracy or Stacy, who wants a long shot relationship. So, yes, that has been Misconnections.
You would think after all that, there would be some type of name dropping going on or some identifying marks.
This guy was trying to write the Iliad and the Odyssey for a long shot with Stacy from the Trade Wind like Lounge.
Trying to have a press conference.
Yeah, right.
I know. Yes.
All right.
10 Second time.
With the ladies, man. Ladies, man, it was always nice talking to you. I know we make this an annual thing, and we appreciate it. Hope to see you next year.
Oh, I hope to be back next year. You know, I got the Rona 3 times. One time it was in my butt. It was weird why they said I got the Rona in my butt. So I'm not going to go into that store. That'll be next year. Okay.
Put that in a misconnection. They'll identify you.
No, because that don't want to be Eric Church or Mitch or Stacey or 10 Second Tom.
Or the bottom.
If you need to find me, I'll be down in Miami underneath the lifeguard tower next to Smelly Pete. That's my roommate underneath the lifeguard tower, Smelly Pete.
All right, ladies, man, thank you very much. Bushman, it's a pleasure. Listen, I miss you every time we do the show, but just make sure you keep coming back every year. That's all.
I will, man. Don't worry. I will.
All right, take care. You have a good night.
See you, man.
All right, bye-bye. Bushman, everybody, making his presence felt here on the Charles Richardson Show on our 6-year anniversary. Always good to bring back the original cast of characters. All right, so we'll take a break. Which finally, 8:16 after sports talk and Bush talk and every other talk and Will talk, we get to go ahead and take a break and maybe burn off some, this energy that I have that's built up for whatever.
We missed soap operas.
Soap operas? Yeah.
We didn't do the update on soap operas.
Oh,
soap
shut operas. Up. Soap operas.
You just want you to feel our pain when we're listening to sports.
You're going
to
put me and David to sleep? Is that what it is?
Well.
Or maybe David will get into it. I don't know.
Good for the goose is good for the game. Actually, he probably would.
He probably would.
Which one are we talking about?
Sometimes you tune in on it, too.
I do. I say, hey, is that Victor? He's still alive? Oh, okay.
I know.
Bridgerton.
Well, yeah, Bridgerton Stephen's was kind
back?
Of. Again? Stefan's back. Tell
no,
a friend.
Stefan's dead.
No, that yes, that's Stefan, but he thinks he's John. And much was Marlene. No, I know.
All right, both of you shut up. I'm going to a break.
All right.
We'll be right back, everybody. Don't go anywhere.
Stay where you are. The Charles Richardson Show will return after this.
All night until you're in the Emotions on the moment of gridlock. Never drop before I'll make a profit. And we saw the Alpha T, such a hot shot. Stupid shock, shock, cheap and hot spot. Nobody asked for a female astronaut. Right heart, when you're lying in the dirt, you fly. Disaster, the master of silence. But now you want to do is bring in the violence from the back. You try hard to distract until you get a turn. Waste of life, it is my waste of time. Keep your voice down, I'm gonna keep myself from breaking my tongue all night until you're in the light. Got the whole room watching you.
Go outside and feel the rain. The feeling that you have inside, you can't explain. You never felt anything wrong, you thought before. It overwhelms and drips it down to your core. You wanna scream, but you just don't remember.
Your dick blows wide on my pussy tonight, not a condom to be seen. A kingdom of penetration, and it looks like I'm queen. I'm moaning, howling, and I cannot close my thighs. I couldn't keep them together, heaven knows I tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the virgin you've always had to be. Conceal, don't squeal, don't let them know. Well, now they know. I'm a hoe, I'm a hoe. Can't hold it back anymore. I'm a hoe, I'm a hoe. I'm a dirty little whore. I don't care what they're going to say. Take your condom off. Your sperm never bothered me anyway. It's funny how the distance makes your dick look so small. And the sperm that once shot through me can't get to me at all. It's time to see what I can do. I'll suck you, blow you, till you spew. No bra, no thong, no clothes for me. I'm free. I'm a hoe, I'm a hoe. Can't hold it back anymore. I'm a hoe, I'm a hoe. I'm a dirty little whore. You fuck my pussy on the bed and on the ground. Your dick is spiraling in little circles around my mouth. A cum shot hits me like a woman gooey mouth. I'm never going back, so stick it in my ass. I'm a hoe, can't hold it back anymore. I'm a hoe, I'm a hoe, I'm a dirty little whore. I don't care what they're going to say. Your sperm never bothered me anyway.
We're back to the best show you have never heard of. That's the Charles Richardson Show.
You trash!
Gonna take a census here or a vote, because if we do this, everybody's doing it. It's either gonna be Facebook memes now or Karaoke later, briefly, and then we go to good news. Which one do you want to do first? Because we're all going to do it. But when we go do karaoke, we're doing a song apiece. Everybody is. Yes. Yes.
No. Yes. You know I don't sing.
Well, I know. Neither do I. And neither does David.
I don't either. But
so we're all doing it. So but I just need to know which one you're doing first.
Memes. Give me more time.
More time for memes. So I will pick a song and put the camera on you. And that's up
and
to
I
you.
Will sit there and not sing. Not going to sing.
So you're not going to be a part of the show then?
Come on,
why
Alyssa.
Are you here?
Be like a virgin.
Right, exactly. All right, there you go. That's the song, Like a Virgin. We're gonna play Madonna's Lightning Bridge. That's perfect, actually. So.
No.
We'll go ahead and put Madonna Like a Virgin for Alyssa. Karen, do you have an idea of what song you wanted to have played?
I am not singing that song.
You're not singing any song anyway, so what does it matter to you?
You should do one of her boy band songs.
She should, but you know what? She's over here being a little killjoy.
She knows that one. Or all of them. Strawberry Wine.
Strawberry Wine? What was that noise? Is that Stefan in here?
No.
So I heard. Struggle.
John Monroe said, hey, I'm not here for nothing.
Oh, no, no. He's there. I saw him. I said hi. W. Berry Wine. Let's see what comes up. All right. And Dina Carter?
Yeah.
All right. Cool. We will load that up. All right. Added. And I get Like a Virgin.
No,
David,
I'm
you
want to
do YMCA?
No, I ain't doing no damn YMCA.
Come on, construction worker.
Well, what do you want to do? You want to do something from 98 Degrees? Backstreet Boys? NSYNC? No, not NSYNC. I'll get clipped for that.
You're already pushing it by trying to make me sing.
Oh, will you stop it? Have some fun.
What are you singing, Charles?
I don't know. I'll sing. You know what? I'll even sing whatever you want me to sing there.
See,
David.
John says he wants to hear you sing.
Because I will go ahead. I want to hear her sing too.
I need to sing something country.
You need to,
something country.
Country.
What is? I think he should sing Redneck Woman.
Oh no, no, yeah. No, no, no.
Oh,
No.
Wait a second.
Or we could go with Man, I Feel Like a Woman.
Wait a second. Okay, hold on. That's a good idea, but we have to pick something for her, and she does have to sing.
Okay.
No matter how horrible it is.
I'll do it.
And the same thing with me. You guys can pick whatever you want from me. Karen.
You're mean.
No, it's all
song,
in fun.
I like
we're
big
all,
butts.
We're all big butts.
Sir Mix-a-Lot.
That's what you should sing, Charles.
Wow.
You
okay.
Know you do.
Okay, I mean, I can
you
do
don't
that.
Disagree with that.
I'll go.
So Karen's the only one that actually gets to pick her fucking song.
That's right, because it's called Karaoke.
That's true.
Okay, Karen gets picked on all the time. I get to pick my damn song.
I'd say Barbie Girl.
No, because I did that one already and embarrassed myself because I didn't know that was the words.
I don't care.
I thought it was some cute little song. I didn't know it was perverted.
Every song is perverted anymore.
Well, I was going to say Strawberry Wine is it, but yeah, it is. It's about summer fling.
Let's do the memes first, and we'll go to get the Karaoke here. We'll have we'll start off with the star of the show, of course, Karen. All right, here's the memes. I've been told I catch more flies with honey, but I can catch plenty of flies with your dead carcass, so I'm good either way.
Yep.
This could go either way. Oh, man. My attitude is as big as my boobs, you've been warned.
We need that shirt, Alyssa.
Calm down, Karen. It's just allergies. Heifer. I will put you in the trunk and help people look for you. Stop playing with me. We the people got that WAP. Wrong ass president. When your mom gives a pre-ripped half piece of double mint gum and it tastes like perfume and purse dirt.
Because that's what you used to get. Is you'd ask for a piece of gum, and your mom and your grandma would pull it out of her purse.
Yeah, they'd pull a half a stick.
Yeah, because that's all they would do.
They would always rip it in half.
So 10 kids can pick up 5,000 eggs in a yard the size of a football field in 10 minutes, but it takes them 3 months to pick up 5 toys in a small bedroom. Mm-hmm. You have firsthand knowledge of that. When life gives you lemons, and there's a picture of a lemon on the forehead of Joe Biden, Trump at the bottom smiling, send that shit back and demand an orange. there's a picture of a pickle. Paint me green and call me a pickle because I'm done dealing with you bitches. Here's a really old grandma blouse. When y'all can go broke in Victoria's Secret, all you want is... Okay, y'all can go broke in Victoria's Secret all you want, but
These are the gowns that your grandfather making 10 to 12 babies and paying all the bills.
That's right. It's no, a nightgown that every grandmother wears.
Yeah, pretty much. Pleasing a girl isn't expensive. It costs zero to let it sit on your beard. It was a couple from Melissa, but again, Facebook
I
likes to go
some
ahead.
Funny ones. And you did. You're not even going to read.
But the funny thing is going to be having you sing. Here, here's one. Oh, okay. Here's the Easter egg one with the Kahlua. Let me see if I can pull that one up. There we go. Come on, come on, come on.
Oh, that wasn't really a meme. That just looked good.
It was. Oh, really? Oh.
Well, I mean, you could.
It could be a meme. Adult Easter eggs just add Baileys. So it's got cracked open chocolate Easter eggs. And,
yeah, chocolate Easter eggs, and then they pour Baileys.
And then you get the Ooh. Baileys. That sounds like fucking yummy.
So this one, I saw it was a picture of Joe Biden and has a quote, "If you do your part, there's a good chance you may be able to have a small barbecue in your backyard for 4th of July." And then it says Texas, and it's got a picture of, what's his name?
Trump?
No, it's Wahlberg.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, okay. Mark Wahlberg. And he's got this look like, what the hell? And it says, y'all stop barbecuing?
All right, there's your memes.
Not in Texas, Florida.
For Wednesday, March 31st, 2021, day one of the two-show spectacular known as the sixth anniversary week of the Charles Richardson Show. So happy that everybody has decided to join us. We thank you very much for tuning in. Make sure if you like the show, share the show. Share it with your friends. Tell your friends. We've been around for 6 years and we haven't gotten dick. So come on.
Well, I've gotten some.
Well, you've gotten plenty. All right. I have made an executive decision. Oh, we are not. Karen is not going to choose strawberry wine. We are going to choose for her. So let's go ahead and get some. Let's get some songs here that we can have Karen sing. Barbie Girl was one of them that you
I
had
did
suggested.
That one last time.
Okay. Then we can't have him sing, no. sing Barbie Girl again.
Material Girl by Madonna.
Well, we already have, right now, so far, we only have...
I am not singing like a virgin.
Well, what do we have in Alyssa sing?
I think she should do something by her boys.
But we got to choose it for her.
I don't know any of their songs.
What's NSYNC songs again?
I Want It That Way. An NSYNC song, and if you think NSYNC sings I Want It That Way, I'm getting a divorce right now.
That sounds like a threat.
You know who sings it, Charles.
I know. But, no, all right, so what's the new one from Backstreet Boys? Let me look up Backstreet Boys.
There's a new one from Backstreet Boys?
The newest
one. It's like a year old.
Yeah, it's a year. But she likes the As Long As You Love Me, and that sounds kind of girly anyway when they all sing it together. It's kind of high-pitched. I think that's a fair song to sing. I know. Nobody
Period.
Can sing. That's the
I
problem.
Can't sing either.
Nobody can sing. That's the problem. All right. Stop. So As Long As You Love Me, I think that's one we should do. Okay. So we save that one. What were you going to sing, David? What did we agree David was going to sing?
Redneck Woman.
Redneck Woman.
Gretchen Wilson.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Redneck Woman, he's a country bitch ass whore.
I like that version.
All right. Okay, got that one.
Can I hit the nail on the head?
I got it on the head, all right. Let's see.
Just the tip,
right? Okay, As Long As You Love Me, Redneck Woman. What does everybody want me to sing? But Baby Got Back?
Yes.
All right, we'll do Baby Got Back.
That's not fair because he's got a really fun one.
So do you.
Yeah, fun
I don't
for
know
us
anything
to hear.
About that song.
I've sang that song.
But it. I've never tried to sing that song.
Well, I would hope not.
I mean, I've never tried to memorize that song.
I can see you a cut off That's not what I meant. That song.
John, what are you trying to say? Because your comments are coming up blank.
One of those.
Oh, because they're no. He says
crop tops with the
yeah,
the
tie.
Yeah,
the
plaid one.
Hear you, and then it's got a skeleton dancing.
the fucking exactly. Daisy Duke shorts and the fucking cowboy boots.
All right, so we got to figure out what...
That's what Tony D needs to take a picture of.
All right, we got to figure out what Karen's singing. Oh, we want to keep strawberry wine with for her.
No.
Keep strawberry wine. No. Have some mercy on our listeners.
No. No.
No, there's no. 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 David, what should Karen sing?
Let's see.
Make it something I know.
Save a cowboy, ride a tractor or something like that. Or ride a...
Save a horse, ride a cowboy. Oh, yeah, there you go.
Save a horse, ride a cowboy.
Okay, we can do that.
Right, we'll do that.
I was going to say It's Raining Men.
Oh, oh, David, do we agree on that?
I don't know that one, though.
That's okay. You don't need to.
Oh, my God.
David, do we agree on It's Raining Men?
It's Raining Men.
I know the chorus. That's it.
Yes. All right. Well, that's good. That's all you need to know, really. It's Raining Men. Hallelujah.
Glenn, it's about everything. Anything and everything. Some of it's your worst nightmares. Sexual fantasies. Now we're going to do karaoke.
There we go. All right. It's time for karaoke, everybody.
Wait a minute. We were talking about sexual fantasies on here?
No, no, no. I don't remember hearing that.
It's a fantasy. That's what. Yep. It's all in our head.
All right, everybody. So it is time to go ahead and sing our little tushies off. It is karaoke. And it's all Glenn wants to know what's the show about. John, he was talking to you, so go ahead. So the reason why we're calling it karaoke is Karen's got the best voice on here on the show to sing any type of karaoke. But see, here's the thing is now where everybody's going to sing.
Y'all might want to get your earplugs ready.
Yeah. May want to get your earplugs.
Noise-canceling headphones if you need them.
Noise-canceling headphones, or you just want to turn the fucking show off. Maybe that's what it is.
Right now would be the time to do that.
So, here we go. The songs that we have, As Long As You Love Me, Baby Got Back, It's Raining Men, and Redneck Woman. I think David should go first.
I think so, too.
No, 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 no.
Yes.
It's Karen. No, no. It's karaoke. It's Karen.
That's right. And so we say the best for last.
Ladies first. Nope.
Best for last.
It is best for last. I'm not going
first.
Yep.
You are going first.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
This bullshit.
Just push play.
Fine. You know what? I'll be the sucker. I'll go ahead and go first.
You go ahead. Okay? Go for it. Yeah, go for it.
Then you're next, bitch.
Motherfucker. No, it should be guy, girl, guy, girl.
No, shut up. It's
guys
happening.
Supposedly have the balls.
Just it's happening. Leave it alone. Just come to peace with it. Because I have to do the shit too, all right? All right, so let me get the volume up and running here.
Now, it is going to show on this other TV, correct?
It is.
Because I don't know a damn thing about mine.
No, it's okay. So here we go. Oh, come on. Wait. Yeah. Uh-oh, hang on a second. Wait a second. This sucks. All right, so what's happening is the audio is going either one or the other. It's either going to the TV or it's going to the mixer. So I'm going to have to share, if you know what I mean.
Okay.
So let me... All right. What are we doing here? This is working before. Why is this not working now? There we go. Let's try this again.
Oh my God, Becky, look at her butt. It's so big. She looks like
rap guys' girlfriends. But, you know, who understands those rap guys? They only talk to her because she looks like a
don't worry,
total
I'm gonna give everybody
prostitute.
This
okay,
when it's time.
I mean her butt.
All right, here
is
we
so
go.
Big. I can't believe it's just so round. It's like out there. I mean, ugh, gross. Look, she's just so black.
I like big butts and cannot lie. You other brothers can't deny. When a girl walks in with an itty bitty waist and around things in your face, you get sprung like you want to pull a rope because you know it's clever stuff.
deep in the jeans she's wearing. I'm hooked and I can't stop staring. Oh, baby, I want to get with ya and take your picture. My homeboys tried to warn me, but that butt took me.
Makes so horny.
Ooh, rumpo smooth skin. Say, want to get my bends? Well, use me, because you ain't that average groovy. I have seen them dancing. The hell with romance, and she's sweat and wet. Got it going like a turbo vet. I'm tired of magazines saying fat butts are the thing. Take the average black man and ask him that. She got a pack much back. So fellas, yeah! Fellas, yeah! Has your girlfriend got the butt?
Hell yeah!
Shake it. Shake that healthy butt. Baby got back.
LA Bank with the open booty.
That was pretty good.
Not bad, huh? Baby got back. I like them round and big, and when I'm throwing the gig, I just can't help myself. I'm acting like an animal. Now here's my scandal. I want to get you home and I'm talking about Playboy, because silicone parts are made for toys. I want them real thick and juicy, so I find that juicy bubble. Mix lots in trouble, begging for a piece of that bubble. So I'm looking at rock videos. Knock-kneed bimbos walking like hoes. You can have those bimbos. I like my women like Flojo. A word to the thick soul sisters, want to get with ya. I won't cuss or hit ya, but I gotta be straight when I say, oh, gonna break of dawn, baby got it going on. A lot of slims like, well, yeah. Cause them punks all here to hit and quit it. And I'd rather stay and play, cause I'm long, I'm strong, I'm down to get friction on. So lady, yeah! You wanna roll my Mercedes?
Yeah!
And turn around, stick it out. You white boys got to shout, baby got that. Yes, Mo, I'm talking about Alyssa. Baby got back. Yeah, baby, when it comes to females, Cosmo ain't got nothing to do with my selection. 36, 24, 36. Only if that's the age. So your girlfriend rolls a Honda, playing workout tape by Fonda. But Fonda ain't got a motor in the back of her Honda. My Anaconda don't want none unless you got buns, hun. You can do side bends or sit-ups, but please don't lose that butt. Some brothers want to play that hard role and tell you that the butt is gold. They toss it, leave it, and I'll pull up quick to retrieve it. So Cosmo says you're fat. Well, I ain't down with that, because your waist is small and your curves are kicking. And I'm thinking about licking.
Oh!
But the bean pulled down to the magazines, you ain't it, Miss Thing. Give me a sister, I can't resist her. Red beans and rice and mister. Some knucklehead tries to diss, because the girls are on my list. He had game, but he chose to hit him. I pull up quick to get with him. So the aliens, if the butt is round, and you want a triple X throw down, that 1-900 mix a lot and kicks them nasty thoughts. Baby got back. Yeah. What? I said baby's got back. Work it. Break it down. Something like that. A little milk, but I got much back. A little in the middle, but she's got much back.
That was pretty good.
All right, I'm done. I got mine out of the way. See, David, it could have been you to get it out of the way, but
yeah.
No, you wanted to chose to be a little bitch. That's what I'm talking about. Okay. Oh, my God. All right. One down. David's next.
Son of a bitch.
And he's going to be singing Redneck Woman. Okay. Now.
No pressure, but I did some work and we're up to, you know, 8 Facebook viewers right now.
Are you fucking
9, actually. Well, I just went to 8. Date, I'm going to need. How are we going to do this? Hold on a second.
Pineapples for all.
Yeah, right. Stop that.
You ready?
No, he's not ready.
You ready to twang it?
He's ready to twang it. All right, so here's what I need. David, you better not screw this up.
Oh my God.
Mo said, Go, Dave.
Turn this
well, of
shit
course,
off.
That's like the boy. That's his boyfriend.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, he needs that. Let me see if this works.
He's got to have his encouragement.
Yeah.
His little cheerleader.
You
got those pom-poms ready, Mo?
And we have the pom-poms ready.
David's got the Daisy Dukes.
Uh-huh. All right, now we
calm down.
Calm down, killer.
Son of a bitch.
All right, full screen mode. Honey, I need you to pass this over as far as Dave can get
Diamond
it.
Diamond Dave.
Diamond Dave, right.
Oh, my God.
Coming live to you tonight.
There you go.
On our anniversary show.
That's right. And when you're ready, David, press the play. There should be a little play button somewhere up there. Fuck. And if he can't find it, listen, can you help him?
Okay.
Lisa, go David Moyer's David.
Lee. All right, here we go. This is David.
Oh, my God. Y'all gonna fucking kill me here. I never. No, I can't sweat sweet champagne. I'd rather drink beer all night in a tavern. Bring a honky-tonk, on a four-wheel drive tailgate. Got posters on my wall, Cliff Skinner. It's straight. Some people look down on me, but I don't give a rip. I'll stand there, hooded in my front yard with the baby on my hip. Cause I'm a...
Come on!
Ain't no high class, bro.
I'm just a product of my raising. I say, hey, y'all, and me. I keep my Christmas lights on my front porch all year long. And I know all the words to every Charlie Daniels song.
I bet he does.
So here's to all my sisters out there keeping it country. Let me get a big hell yeah from the redneck girls like me.
Gretchen's crying right now.
Oh, she is.
Victoria's Secret. Well, their stuff's real nice. Oh, but I can have the same damn thing on shelf half price and still look sexy. Just as sexy as those models on TV. No, I don't need no designer to make my man want me.
Keep going.
A little too hardcore. But in my neck of the woods, I'm just the girl next door. Woo! I know my class frog. I'm just a product of a raisin. And I said, hey, y'all, and me. I keep my Christmas lights on my front porch all year long. And I know all the words to every Tanya Tucker song. So here's to all my sisters, they're keeping it country. Let me get a big hell yeah from the redneck girls like me.
Hell yeah!
Come on. I know there's stuff in there.
This is a break right now.
Is it a
break?
Oh,
yeah. You doing all your yeehaws?
Yeehaw!
Woo-hoo! Sound like you were strangling.
I'm a redneck woman. I ain't no high-class broad. I'm just a product of my raising. I say, hey, y'all, and yeehaw. Oh, keep my Christmas on my front porch all year long. And I know all the words to every old Bo Cephas song. So here's to all my sisters out there keeping it country. Let me get a big hell yeah from the redneck girls like me.
Hell yeah!
Hell yeah! Hell yeah! I said hell yeah!
Yeah, you did. Mo's over there saying he can't read, let alone karaoke.
I can fucking read.
He says, I'll be making a donation to helping kids learn to read modern David.
Fucking eyes were watering from laughing too hard. I couldn't see the words.
All right. Let me
shut up, Mo.
Mo will be here Friday.
That you're going to fucking sing Friday, Mo.
No, actually we're not.
He can.
No, but I mean, we could think about maybe getting him to sing.
No, we're going to make Mo sing. He's gonna sing like a virgin.
Can't be gonna sing no more.
All right, Alyssa's next.
No, I'm not.
I said you are.
No, yes, I'm not.
You're doing it.
No,
and
just do it.
Just do it.
No,
just do it.
Why do I have to go?
Because I had to go.
Charles had to go. Doing it.
You never made me do it before.
No, I'm making you do it now.
Well, this is the fun show. Damn it!
This is the new year.
It's supposed to be
It's supposed
to be. There's nowhere to put it.
Yeah, there is. Right there. Thank you, Karen.
You're welcome. Was not really on Alyssa's purpose. Like, she
you're such an asshole.
She's not going to do it. Go ahead and touch as long as you love me. And go ahead and hit the play.
Yeah, this is happening. As long as you love me.
What are you going to do if I just sit here and do nothing?
Well, you're just a sore sport.
Yeah. That I mean, that's being serious.
Tommy said it wasn't bad.
All right, here we go.
Lee said you did a good job reading.
Always been a friend of mine. I'm leaving my life in your hands. People say I'm crazy and that I am blind, risking it all in a land. And how you got me blind is still a mystery. I can't get you out of my head. That throws me off big time. Don't care what is written in your history. As long as you're here with me, I don't care who you are, where you're from, what you did. As long as you love me, who you are, where you're from, don't care what you did. As long as you love me, every little thing that you have said and done feels like it's deep within me. Ooh, 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 doesn't really matter if you're on the run. As long as you're mad.
What, they changed the words!
Who you are, where
you're from, what you did. As long as you love me, who you are, where you're from, don't care what you did. As long as you love me, yeah. As long as you love me. I've tried to hide it so that no one knows, but I guess it shows. When I look into your eyes, what you did and where you're coming from, I don't care. As long as you love me, baby.
Oh, baby.
I'm not going to do all these O's.
Oh, come on.
I had to.
Oh. We want to hear you.
Oh.
Who you are, where you're from, what you did. As long as you love me, who you are, where you're from, what you did.
Lots of love.
As long as you love me, who you are, where you're from, what you did. As long as you love me, who you are, where you're from, what you did. Oh. As long as you love me, what you did, I don't care. As long as you love me.
All right.
And I did most of that one. Not even helping get the words.
That was good. You know, that's probably the truth. You know that song so well. Back and forth.
Sorry. I have a good grip on it.
I'm going to bring this to Karen.
Good job.
Yeah, good job. I mean, honestly, you did a good job.
Yeah. Charles, you know? All kinds of love, Alyssa.
Right. It's Raining Men. Ugh. Time for Karen to suck it up.
Nobody, I do not know this song, so of course.
Okay, it's don't worry about it.
It's Raining Men. Hallelujah.
Okay, so
Karen, do Reba. They said they chose my song.
Okay, so at the top right, you got this. I mean, this is kind of like not the greatest. But at the top right, there should be a play button. You play, song please. You sing.
She missed.
Oh, yeah.
He missed.
I think he meant
public. Let's
see. Quick.
It's our travel moment.
All right, you may run a little bit over, folks. All my affiliates, if you run over, you'll feel about us all.
Hi, what girl? I assume this. Haha. I've got news for you. You better listen. Get ready, all you lonely girls. And leave those umbrellas. Humidity is rising. Rising. Is this supposed to be spoken?
Singing now.
Oh.
According to all sources, the streets.
I have no idea how this goes. Tonight for the first time, just about half past 10, for the first time in history, it's gonna start raining men. It's raining men, hallelujah, it's raining men, amen. It's, I have no idea how this goes. Gonna let myself get absolutely soaking wet. It's raining men. Hallelujah. It's raining men. This sounds really bad. Tall, blonde, dark and lean, rough and tough and strong and free. I bless Mother Nature. She's a single woman too. This is terrible. I have no idea how this goes. What she had to do. She taught every angel. She arranged the sky so that each and every woman finds her perfect guy. It's raining men. Hallelujah, it's raining men. Amen, it's raining men. Hallelujah, it's raining men. Amen. Amen, and this is over. I have no idea. It sounded cuter when the kids sang it. I feel stormy weather moving in.
Just follow the letters as they highlight. That's what you're supposed to read. As they highlight, that's what you
read. Okay, so slow. About to begin. Hear the thunder. Don't you lose your head. Rip off the roof and stay in bed.
Wow.
I have no idea.
That's good.
Bless Mother Nature. She's a single woman too. She took off to heaven. She did what she had to do. She taught every angel. She arranged the sky so that every woman could find a perfect guy. And it's raining men. Can't just what? Listen. Humidity's rising.
Hey, David, I'm thinking this wasn't as fun as we thought it would be.
No, it's not. It's low, 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 low.
Low, low, low.
It's getting low.
I'll bet you
according
are.
According to our sources. Yeah.
The streets are place to go.
Tonight, for the first time, just about half past 10. For the first time in history, it's gonna start raining men. It's raining men. Hallelujah, it's raining men. Amen, it's raining men. Hallelujah, it's raining men. Amen.
I just read most comments. There's like show some cleavage. No. Would that save it?
I think it for him, it might.
Oh,
paying too much.
Oh, oh, oh.
That's not how you sound.
They'll never choose my song for me again, ever. There's a reason I never sing that song.
I guess so. We found out the reason tonight.
The background sounds real jazzy and bluesy, and I'm like, did I try to sing like them? And it's not coming out right at all.
No, it's not.
Oh,
all right. Hey, listen,
so who won tonight?
They said most, David is the winner.
Yeah, David apparently is the winner because he gets to go home.
Oh, God.
That's the reason. Listen, well, thank everybody for tuning in, even though a lot of you guys tuned in late. We did go over mega time. We appreciate it, though, that, listen, share the show, like the show, follow us on Facebook and Twitter. But we are out of here. This is night one. Next night, to finalize everything, it's Friday, April 2nd, and we'll have Matt D and Mo in here along with the not-so-newlywed game. We're going to have a lot of fun, so come on back for Friday, 7 p.m. Eastern, right here on the Charles Richardson Show. Good night, everybody. Take care. We're out.
Be out of here. We are out of here.
Yeah, it's true. Been there before. But now the sun don't hurt me. It blinded me permanently.